Yo everyone and welcome back to the channel, it's Tizaf Addict and we're back with SAO Airways. As usual, as fucking usual, we have new units. As usual, not even 1 week since the last event and we have new units, let's go. So actually first I wanna check Tap Tap Asuna. I want to check her day locks when you tap tap, so let's go. I knew it all along, you're the strongest guy. Of course Asuna. Are you hungry? No. It's been a while since you and I sat down for a nice long talk. Let's change that. Oh, look at her face. What do you mean, Asuna? Like a nice long talk? Ah, what is this? The rain is like some music, okay? I was surprised at first. I would never thought that the absolute sword was a woman. Looks like we'll be together all day. What do you want to do? Oh, I want to do a lot of things, Asuna. Okay, holy shit, that's so awkward. So, let's go check the units, actually. Like, you know, usually I do a video for reviewing units, but this time I didn't do that because I woke up and I found that they were releasing new units. Like, I was asleep all along and then when I woke up I see that they're releasing new units. I didn't know anything about that, so let's go, let's check them out. We have new Tees and new Yu-Gi-Oh and later we'll roll, I guess. Actually first I want to check if they're good or not, but apparently we have a free multi. Yeah, here it is, 11 times free first time, so we'll do the free multi and we'll check if they're good, and if they are, we'll do more multis, I guess. So let's go. I think it's as usual. Like, step up with guaranteed 4-star at 5th step. Yeah, it's the same thing. So the usual thing, and let's go. Actually, I don't wanna read all that bullshit. Let's just start reading through over here. So what does he have? Okay, he has high HP. Yeah, he has very high HP, actually. Maybe one of the highest, like maybe top 5, even top 3, actually. Yeah, I think top 3 highest HP in the game. 6,800, and the speed is kinda meh. I mean, it's over 310, so it's okay, but compared to all characters, like the latest Yuki, he's not the fastest, so he's shit. That's my logic, okay? If it's not the best, it's shit. Then let's check his skills. Like, the only noticeable stats are the HP and the speed, but the other stats aren't that interesting. Maybe the attack. Yeah, the attack is good, but all 4 stars have a good attack actually, so it doesn't matter. He's a charged character. Okay, skill connects tip slant slash attack on single enemy, allows physical. Oh, that's good. Charge attack with physical res debuff. We love that. And then assault skill slash attack on single enemy deals additional damage on enemies inflicted with physical res or magic arts. Oh no, Bamko, don't tell me you're recycling the bullshit from the previous event. No, 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 don't do that, please. No, what's the third skill? Oh my god, the third skill is a debuff. Don't tell me they're recycling the same thing from the last event with Yuki and AL Asuna. No, no, no. Quick and feeble earth. Oh god, they're doing it. They're recycling again. No, I hate it when they do that. Like, come on. Like, if they do it for now, like, they recycled from previous event, I guess they're gonna do the recycling thing for all future events until they have the same ability for all elements. Like, last event it was for dark element, and this one is for earth element, and then later we get wind element, and wait, it's wind element actually, not earth element. But it's a debuff on earth elemental enemies, so it lowers physical res and magic res for a single enemy by 10%, and it becomes 20% if the enemy is earth elemental, so it's the same thing as the latest event with Yuki and Asuna, but this one works on earth units. But last event it worked on what units? I think light units. Yeah, light units, so literally just the opposite element. And his incarnate, Blue Sword of Blooming Life. Oh, interesting. Incarnate slash attack on all enemies, additional slash attack on single enemy, absorbs HP from affected enemy, and this added damage on enemies. Holy shit, that's so long. Okay, so to make it simple, from what I understand, it's an AoE attack, but it deals bonus damage on a single target, and it absorbs HP from affected enemy. Okay, but it's kinda sad because it absorbs HP for Yu-Gi-Oh only, I guess. Not for the whole party. If it was an AoE HP buff, it would have been better, but it's still fine. And this added damage on enemies inflicted with physical res or magic res debuff. It's just like last event too! Like, the thing with added damage on enemies inflicted with physical res or magic res debuff is the same as last event, but the other things are not the same, so I think this is the first time we get AoE attack with bonus damage on a single target, actually. So, he's not bad, I guess, but he's not the best. He's meh. Meh. Like, meh. And actually, fun fact, but I was recording, like, not even recording, I was editing the tutorial list yesterday, and then I ended, editing it, and went to sleep, and then I wake up, I find a new event, so those units are not gonna be included in the tutorial list. Actually, maybe it's already up when I upload this. Is the tutorial list up when I upload this? Well, if it's up, go watch it, if you didn't watch it already, so I don't know how I'm gonna include them in the tutorial list, I'll check out later. And yeah, so he's not bad. But I don't recommend rolling for him. This is kind of like a bait banner. Like later we might get Dusselbert or that Del waifu. Yeah, Del waifu. Well, you know who I'm talking about, right? The mommy waifu. So I'm saving for that. So I'm not really gonna roll for him. But if you need wind characters, I recommend rolling for Yu-Gi-Oh because he does look bad. He's not bad. He's okay. He's okay. Yeah, he's okay. And then we have Tease, Quivering Love, Tease, Cringe, Quivering Love, Cringe. Okay, let's check her stats. Okay, her HP is not that high. I think it's like Xenon. Her HP is kind of low, so she's a glass cannon. And she's a mage since her magic attack is higher than her attack. And her speed is just like Yu-Gi-Oh, I think. Same thing, 317, yeah, 317, so it's kind of meh. And her crit, I think she has the highest crit in the game. Crit chance, highest crit chance in the game. Okay, it's good, but like crit is kinda, crit stat is kinda, I don't know, because it's all a matter of luck. Like if you're lucky, you'll get a lot of crits, and if you're not lucky, you'll not get any crits. Like it doesn't matter if you have high crit or not, because it's just a matter of luck, you know what I mean? So I don't know. And then we have her skills, so break character. Magic attack on all enemies, increases incarnate break when enemies are afflicted. So yeah, I think for this month, they have the debuff power creep. It's the same thing for all units, gonna be the same thing. Like they have bonus effects on enemies inflicted with a debuff. But I'm not complaining, it's a nice thing. Like after the continuous damage power creep, we have the debuff power creep. So it's interesting. And assault skill, magic attack on single enemy, inflicted with continuous damage for 3 turns. Okay, and her third skill is the same as Yu-Gi-Oh! Oh, this recycling bullshit. I hate this. I hate it when they recycle the stuff. But it's okay. Enter Incarnate Winds of Noble Justice. Wait, let's do it again. Winds of Noble Justice. Oh, that's nice. Incarnate magic attack on enemies. Additional magic attack on single enemy. Incarnate magic. Ooh, Incarnate break on her Incarnate. Okay, that's gonna be useful. It's actually very useful. Like, if you need some Incarnate to... Wait, if you need some Incarnate, I need... If you need some break to kill the enemy. No. Some break to break the enemy, right? Then you can use this. It can be useful sometimes, so... Don't ignore that break effect, it's very useful. And she's meh too, actually. Yeah, she's kinda meh, she's just like Yu-Gi-Oh. Both are kinda meh. Like, if I had the tier list right now and I should rank them, I would probably put them on B rank. Yeah, probably on B, because they don't have anything exceptional. Like, they have the debuff and stuff, but like, the debuff is only very strong against Earth Elemental enemies. So, you wanna use them in specific quests, like if you get an Earth Elemental event or something. So, actually, you can use them in the current event, I guess, right? And now, let's go roll! Enough bullshit, let's go! And should you do tap-tap? No, I wanna build up my tap-tap luck for Dusselbert or the Del Waifu, so let's not do tap-tap. Let's just start right away with a free multi and let's get it. I wanna do a ritual, but I don't wanna do tap-tap. We don't have any other ritual anyway, so let's go. Let's just roll and whatever. I'm not even interested in any of them, but it would be nice if we get something. Like, even a duplicate. If we get a duplicate, it would be nice, since we get Limit Break crystals. And it took a long time loading, actually, so we might get something. Come on. Start shining. Start shining like bling bling. Bling bling, start shining. Ooh, it's shining, it's shining, it's shining. Is it shining? It's not. Start shining, start glowing. I don't know, do something. Make some noise. Give me a purple door. No? Yikes. Yikes. Oh god, okay. Okay, it's okay, it's okay. That's all because I didn't do tap-tap ritual, okay? You see what happens when you don't do tap-tap ritual? You get this shit. Like, not even 1-4 star. Only 2-3 stars and that's it. Okay, maybe we should do another step. Like, just for fun. Oh no, 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 no. I shouldn't do that. I'm literally wasting my cubes every time. I really shouldn't do that. But maybe we should do it. Ooh, we have discount on this one. Okay, I recommend the rolling at every discount banner because, like, even if you get duplicates from it, it's still nice because you get limit break crystals. So let's go roll here. And it's rate up, like 1.5 rate up. So it can be bad, right? Let's roll at the discount one. So yeah, always roll at discounted banners. Like, at least roll once per banner. Let's go, let's go, let's go. We might get Yuki, actually. Come on, come on, come on. come on, come on, come on. I think it's a rate-up for Yuki. So if you get her, it will be nice. And actually, I got 1 million points in the ranking event. Like, I will upload a video about it soon. And holy shit, I was expecting the 1 million points. Like, for all previous ranking events, I always get, like, 900,000 points. Like, 900,000 curse. And this time, I got 1 million, finally. So come on, come on, start shining. Start shining, no, 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 no. Okay, skip this bullshit. Fuck, come on. Come on, why do you do this? Ooh, actually the points build up. The points like from this banner, you also get points from this banner. So both banners give you points and then you can exchange it for units. But you still need the whale, okay? You need to whale a lot actually. So I'm not gonna do this. And we have this, discount? No, no discount, no discount, no more discount. Or maybe we should draw for weapons. Ah, we have this ticket, guaranteed the unit ticket. So if you don't know what unit to pick, then go check the tier list! So it's actually helpful. If you go check the tier list, you can know which units are good or not. So I'm not the best player in the game, so don't really believe me. Just go for your waifus, okay? Like with this ticket, if you buy it, go for your waifu. But I recommend going for Sinnoh. This Sinnoh or Soulless Sinnoh or Stashia, both are very good. Like, they are the best units in the game with their critical damage buff. Or Terraria Leafa, the three are very strong because of their crit damage buff. Or else you can go for OS Asuna. Or you know what, why am I telling you what to do? Just go for your waifu, okay? Go for your waifu. You also have this one, so this one is kinda simple. Like, if you take a character with this one, then pick their weapon from the weapon ticket, right? What do we have here? Should I roll here? No, not really. I shouldn't roll here. No. Why do I wanna waste my cubes? Why do I wanna waste my cubes? Why am I doing this? I don't wanna waste my cubes. Let's stop it. Just stop before I waste any more cubes. It's connecting. Okay. So, actually we have a new item. Hold on. Where is it? Ah, we have this new event where you can get an Earth Elemental Armor. So, I already cleared it. But we have a new item. Hold on. I think it's over here in the exchange thing. Wait. Ranking event, I guess? No? Ah, it's this one. I think you can use this to exchange for... what are they called already? The Memorias. The illusions, memorias, what are they called? I forgot what they're called, you know, the things that you equip on characters to get bonus stats. I think we can exchange them over here. Imaginarium, yeah, why did I call them memoria? I mean, Imaginarium. Can we exchange? No, I don't know how to exchange them. But I know that you can exchange those crystals for memorias. Not memorias, why am I saying memorias? Imaginarium, freaking Imaginarium. So... don't forget to get those items, and we have those more Imaginarium things. And we have Loli, what's her name? Tease. Loli Tease. So cute. So, look at this. Oh, we even have a Water Elemental accessory. Maybe that means we're getting Fire Elemental event soon? I don't know. That means we're getting a Fire Elemental event and Water units. Okay, that would be interesting if we get Fire units. I mean, Water units, not Fire units. And that's it. Don't have anything else. So, I guess we're done for today's video, right? Or actually, I just noticed it, but some people said that next event would be an event for Kirito and Roni. Because if you see here this event, the current event, like where is it? Let's go to the gacha. Where's the gacha? Where's the freaking gacha? Hold on, gacha? So, if you see here, we have Yu-Gi-Oh and Tease. So, it's teacher and disciple. And like we also have Roni and Kirito and their teacher and disciple too. So we might get that banner soon and they're gonna be Water Elemental. I don't know, I'm just saying that randomly. But if that happens, like it would be so nice. Like predictions and stuff. Holy shit, I'm so smart. Okay, I'm just kidding. But it might happen actually, Roni and Kirito banner next. So save your cubes for that if you want. But I'm not really interested in them either. I just want waifus, okay? Either Dusselbert, he's his bando, or Del waifu, she's waifu. And that's it. So right now we're done for today's video. Here's my friend code. I think I can't add any friends, right? Since the previous video, I can't add any more friends. Like, it's freaking full. Okay, it's full. 36 out of 36. Maybe I have some inactive friends. Hold on. Okay, this is 7 days. But 7 days is not a lot. Like, it needs to be at least 20 days so that I delete you. Oh. This guy is 16 days. Okay, sorry my dude, but I'm gonna unfollow you. Like 16 days, I'm sorry, I'm so sorry, but 16 days, like come on bruh, that's 2 weeks. And now we can add someone. Kirito? No, that's the one we deleted. Oh, who's this? Bruce? Fate Zero is better than Fate Unlimited Blade Works. Change my mind, you can't. That's true, Fate Zero, Kiritsugu versus Bando, I agree. I'm gonna follow you right away. Fate Zero is better than Fate Unlimited Blade Works. And that's facts, okay? Okay, you're not joking, so you can add me if you want. Oh wait, you can't add me. Oh wait, you can add me, but I can't add you. Yeah, you can add me, but I can't add you. So you can add me if you want. Don't forget to leave a like and to subscribe to the channel for more gaming-related content and SEO errors content. Comment down below, ring the notification bell, and I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye, guys!